So we are going to start with the talk today, Materia Medica series, day 7. We have a very special friend also with us today, Dr. Mayuresh Mahajan, who I'm going to invite after my talk as well. So it's just so special to meet all of you today in the evening. Yeah, I think we should start with the talk for today. So we started this Materia Medica series where every single day we are coming up with the remedy, and we are also discussing, and we are inviting guests from everywhere, and it's just so amazing that all the guests who come from different approaches, and they speak about all the different approaches, and it's just great to talk to them as well.
Okay, Alpit, the audio is okay, because I'm getting some messages that the audio is slightly lower.
Yeah, it's better to use the mic actually. If you are using it, keep continuing.
But the audio, is it any better? Can you just check and see and tell me?
Yeah, at my end it's okay. I'm just checking at the other people.
Just check.
Because my audio is okay as well.
It's clear, yeah.
Okay, so I'm going to go ahead in any case. Because we have less time, we have a special speaker with us. In next 45 minutes, I'm going to invite him as well. So we are going to talk about a very, very interesting remedy today. And let's start with the case then. So we are talking about a case of asthma of a 37-year-old lady. And I'm going to tell you the case. And towards the end of the case, I would like to know your views, your suggestions, your analysis, because that is so amazing for me to know every single one of you and how you think. Because the main idea of this webinar is just the way in which we have to study our Materia Medica, and the way in which we have to analyze, and the way in which to see the remedies. So 37-year-old lady comes with asthma, difficulty in breathing, and she has this breathing problem for last 8 years, and she had tuberculosis previously, because of which her lungs were damaged a lot, 50%. And she has this allergic asthma, a lot of breathlessness. She's on many inhalers and allopathic medicines, which we plan to stop. What is interesting is she says that this asthma is worse when she thinks about her complaints. And this anxiety and thinking about the complaints causes aggravation. Walking causes an aggravation. When in crowd causes an aggravation. Narrow places causes an aggravation. Any kind of emotions cause an aggravation. She has a lot of fear of being suffocated. And whenever she goes in a crowd, she feels, and she's very scared. Will she be able to breathe or no? That's a big fear. She is very scared of being suffocated. She cannot breathe properly, and she feels smothered. She feels smothered inside. Unable to breathe at all. What is strange is when she is breathing, and suddenly she starts crying a lot. So there's a very strange connection of breathlessness, anxiety, and emotional state connected to each other. Then she talks about herself. She said, I'm very, very emotional about my family. She says, for me, everything is my family. Meri zindagi meri family hai. And she gets very emotional, very anxious, nervous. And sudden changes in emotions in her. She's very, very emotional. Then she says she's very sensitive towards her father. She says, I'm very attached to him, but he died. And I always used to worry about him. Always worried about her father. there's a lot of fright inside her. She says she's very, very scared of staying alone. Especially when her husband is out, she's very scared. She keeps on thinking, what will happen? Something bad will happen. Something wrong will happen. She keeps thinking about this all the time. And when she thinks about this a lot, her health is affected. This is very strange because as soon as she thinks about her father, she thinks about her complaint, she thinks about all of this, it affects her health a lot. And she weeps, she cries and she cries and she cries. And when you ask her, why are you crying? She says, I cry a lot, I'm very emotional. If I listen to something bad or something sad, it affects me. And then she suddenly laughs. And then she says she cannot take suffering of others. That affects her a lot. Very, very affected by suffering of others. And she says that weeping makes her feel better. Many dreams. She gets dreams of her parents, of her mother, of her father. And she's going to some temple. And very often what she sees comes true. We ask her what was the most stressful situation in her life, and she says the most stressful situation for her life was when the father died. My father was like a friend for me. I used to share each and everything with him. She even tried to do suicide after her father died. She was so attached to him. Lot of attachment to father. And especially the feeling when something bad happened to the father. Very sensitive about family members. And especially what will happen to them. That's a major, major fear. She has a lot of fear of narrow places, and she has extreme desire for reading suspense stories. And she loves chocolates, absolutely loves chocolates. And her sleep is often disturbed due to breathing problems. So what was strange was throughout the case, she was crying between, she was laughing between, she was getting emotional. Very strange the case was. And we were not sure about any remedy. I can see a lot of people are sure about their remedies though. Some people, Dr. Latif Khan says about Ignatia, Dr. Viva speaks about Cyclamen, Pulsatilla, Ayushi, Srimali, and Aditya Dhawan also talks about Pulsatilla. Some more suggestions. Pulsatilla, many people write about Argentum Nitratum. Okay. Please don't jump to remedies. Dr. Samir Chokar is a great teacher. He continues teaching us. Chocolate, Natrum Muriaticum. Just feel the remedy, okay. Dr. Mayuresh from speaker now joins as audience. Don't do that, sir. You're our esteemed speaker, so you're going to be online in next 20, about 30 minutes. Dolly talks about Kali. Dr. Harshna talks about Ignatia. Shraddha talks about Calcarea Ka. Kali. Okay, I'm going to go over the case again very quickly for my new participants. So this patient of ours comes with an asthma, bad asthma, since 8 years. Lungs are badly damaged. Cannot breathe properly. A slightest emotion causes breathlessness. Thinking about it causes breathlessness, lot of suffocation, feels a lot of choking and smothering. And while talking, suddenly she starts crying, gets emotional, very emotional about her family, and gets very nervous very easily, weeps very easily. There is sudden change in emotions for her. Very, very attached to her father, because very, very worried what if something happens to her father. Her whole family is what she is very, very attached about, and gets emotionally choked. Suddenly starts crying when talking about this, gets crying, gets emotional, suddenly laughs, suddenly cries, can't see suffering of others. Lot of dreams, especially dreams of her parents, and especially what she sees can come true. She says when father died, it was very difficult for her. Very worried about family members specifically, and she's scared about narrow places, which is a choking sensation, and her interest is in reading and suspense stories. She's very interested in suspense mystery stories, and this is the case. Are you all with me? So a lot of Ignatias here, okay. Plant remedy, Tushar Kole says. All right. So the idea here is, we all are going to have different approaches, but the idea here is I'm going to just share with you the way I analyze cases. So how to analyze? Let's see if I can analyze. So how to analyze, you know, I'm just going to show you how I analyze rubrics. For me, the most important thing is her breathlessness and asthma and her state of mind. And we are going to connect the state of mind to her physical symptoms. So her breathlessness is very emotional. It's related to emotions a lot. So asthma from emotions. That's the number one rubric for me. The number two rubric is a lot of asthma is often, suddenly she cries, suddenly she laughs. So a little hysterical asthma. Number two rubric. Number three, there is a lot of fear of, let's go to the mind state. Now we are trying to understand the mind state. There's a lot of fear of what? Of suffocation. Fear of suffocation. A lot of fear of suffocation for her. And yes, she suddenly laughs in between. I don't know why. So laughing as well, just broadly laughing. Suddenly her mood changes. Mood, you can see, changeable. And then a very, very interesting rubric, you can see fear, which is connected to how her father is. You can see a very interesting rubric I could find. Fear for his father, fear for her father. And now when you look at the repertory sheet, very interesting, you will see a very, very interesting remedy.
So interesting. We can see the remedy, Moschus. So interesting. And that's what we are going to study today. What is Moschus? And what is the
picture of Moschus? So let us study today the Materia Medica of Moschus. But before we go ahead, so I gave her Moschus in 1 mg potency, one dose, and whenever required, many more repetitions. And very interestingly, her allopathic medicines are stopped. Her asthma is much better now within 3 months of treatment. She's, her state of mind, her anxiety levels are remarkably changed. Her perception of life has changed. And although she's still under treatment, and I wanted to share with you this case, I want to tell you about this case. So let's come back to Materia Medica series day 7, and let's today study about the remedy Moschus. So moschus, about moschus, musk deer, it's an animal remedy. It's very interesting. It is actually formed from the sac at the back of umbilicus, from where the secretions come. Kasturi mrig, it's called as. So interesting. So you can see how the musk deer is. This presentation specially helped by Dr. Juhi and Dr. Srushti Gowde and Dr. Nisha Gangwani. So you have to thank them and not me. I'm just talking, you know, everyone else is doing everything, so it was a joke. In Vedic tradition, it was believed that musk deer, intoxicated by his own smell, would roam the mountains of Himalaya to find it, never realizing that the most beautiful smell was in fact hidden within itself. So interesting. It's almost symbolizing the man going against this kind of pleasures. And as usual, the good scent is always hidden one, the scent of soul. And that's what it's claimed as. And you know, in today's times, musk is a perfume which is very, very popular. And not just this, this is very, very useful in pharmacology for cardiac stimulation. And that's why it is a very important remedy for cardiac pathologies as well. It improves brain function, sexual stimulation. That's why I will talk about sexuality. It improves a lot of spermatozoa, ovum and debility, and special action on medulla. This is the way to study Materia Medica, ladies and gentlemen. To really understand the remedy, not just by rubrics, not just by Materia Medica, but toxicological understanding, physiological understanding, and that's what we are trying to do, to take everything together. This is the new age, this is the new times, and this is the new us. You know, if I have to explain moschus and with the few case examples, if there's one thing I want you to learn, it's the first four lines of Kent Materia Medica. And Kent writes, moschus cures many hysterical girls who have come to adult age without ever learning what obedience means. They are self-willed, obstinate and selfish. And when they have been encouraged to resort to crafty cunning, to have every whim gratified from infancy to 18 years age, they become fit subjects for moschus. So they are very, very hysterical, self-willed, obstinate and very cunning. So what I'm going to do for you is actually now explain you the main state of moschus. And for me to explain you moschus, one of the main states of moschus is extreme attention-seeking behavior. Extreme attention-seeking, and very often they can resort to any means for this attention-seeking. One of the famous rubrics of moschus is seeming sick, acting, pretending that they are sick. More about this by Dr. Mayuresh a little later. One of the very, very commonest dreams which I have seen with moschus is this of dreams of stinking, dreams of excrements. And this also shows a lot of hidden dirt that is there in their life actually, which they are trying to hide. Probably also shows psychotic miasm. Moschus are extremely, extremely hypochondriacal and hysterical, and that's why a very interesting rubric, they have a desire to swallow a large amount of drugs. For me, the main genius of moschus, which I have to teach you, the genius of moschus is attention seeking, extreme hysterical, sudden fear, choking, spasms, feeling and victim feeling. When you see all of this together, this is moschus. a very important word you will see in all Materia Medicas, wherever you speak about MOSCIS, is the word hysteria. It's very strange because the word hysteria comes from the word uterus. And that's what in older times, when the emotional state of mind is very affected, especially people would say it is in females, it's coming from the uterus. One of the things you will see with MOSCIS is they are fine for 1 minute, and second minute there will be sudden fit of anger. That's a very important thing. Suddenly they'll get very angry. With anger they'll have a livid face, lot of weakness, so much of anger they could stab anyone. It's very, very important, this kind of anger. And very often when you are asking them questions, they will answer in a very strange way, in a very confused way. Haan, theek hai, ho raha hai, kya bol raha hai, kya bolne ka. They have this attitude in them, a little, not exactly ego, but you can say a brat, a spoiled brat. That's what they are. Answer aversion to also you will see. Typically in your practice, when they come for follow-up, they'll be complaining. Why am I not getting better? Why is my husband like this? Why are they like this? And all this with a lot of anxiety and hypochondriacity about their health. Complaining. But it's a very interesting rubric. Complaining about one's condition, unable to indicate what is wrong. So interesting. It's a central rubric. There is only one remedy in there. Complaining about illness, unable to indicate what is wrong. This actually shows the deep hypochondriasis and hysteria. Peculiar laugh, you know. You cannot give MOSCIS without its very, very peculiar way of laughing. Suddenly they will laugh out of nowhere. Sometimes little bit, sometimes immoderately. They keep laughing. And sometimes a little nervous laugh. And sometimes paroxysm, uncontrollable type of laugh. Shrieking type of laugh. And often very, very alternating. So you will often see that this kind of laugh is alternating with shrieking. One of the things that I have often seen with MOSCIS patients is they are very attention seeking. So they are constantly doing something with the hand, they are doing something with the button, they are doing something with the, something they will do, you know, gestures with hands, gestures constantly over the head, and gestures where they play with their buttons a lot. So there's a very interesting rubric in Kent also, gestures playing with buttons of his clothing. MOSCIS. So interesting, no? The other thing that you will see is a lot of victim feeling in MOSCIS. There's a lot of victim feeling. So they feel the world is against them. There's a very interesting rubric where they feel that the world is against them. There's a very interesting rubric. Let me show you, if I can show you here. Okay, you can see this here. Delusion opposed by everyone. You can see this. This is MOSCIS. Opposed by everyone. This is MOSCIS. Typically. A lot of victim feeling. A very important rubric here is also hypochondriasis. And what is hypochondriasis? It's chronic anxiety about one's health. It's interesting to understand the rubric hypochondriasis. Hypo means under and chondrias means cartilage. This is the way the word actually was formed. Over exaggeration. And often this hypochondriasis is related to sexuality. Hypochondriatic sexuality. Often related to weakness. Hypochondriasis weakness. The mind is often very blank, lamenting from pain. lamenting about disease and often about imaginary disease. Actually, nothing has happened. Pathologically, structurally, everything is normal. Very interestingly, hysteria in men has only one remedy, mosquitoes. Being a mammal remedy, you know, mosquitoes belongs in mammal family. They are typically, you will think they are Kalika, very anxious about family, very attached to their family, very attached to the mother. There's a lot of maternal instinct in there, almost like lac canine. A lot of hysteria as well. But they have a lot of animal qualities also, but typically more of a victimhood, more of kill desire, more of jumping. What else do you see in this? There's a lot of intoxicated kind of talk, you know. The way they talk, it can be very intoxicating. Someone asked me, how is the Kali quarrelsomeness? There's a lot of quarrelsomeness, and not just quarrelsomeness, they are constantly fighting. But the fighting is always connected to a lot of anger, and after that there's a lot of weeping. So there's a very interesting rubric: quarrelsome, anger after weeping. Someone asked me how to differentiate Drosera. The main feeling of Drosera is someone is cheating me, delusion, deceived, and a constant feeling as if I'm trapped. That is the feeling, because in Drosera there's a lot of experience of being trapped. The anger and the quarrelsomeness can be extreme. They can go to any extreme for quarrels. The rage, the cursing, the maliciousness, this is all animal qualities that you see in mosquitoes. There's a little mischievousness also. They are brats, they are mischievous also. But very often you will see mosquitoes pathology being connected to a lot of breathlessness and asthma, or often related to digestive problems, or often related to conduct. Hysterical element is very, very common in this, yes. But the central peculiarity in mosquitoes is restlessness, sensitive, spoiled nature, and you'll see that mosquitoes. Spoiled. Spoiled is a very important terminology for mosquitoes. Children who don't want to go to school at all, and they will deceitfully kind of do it for their parents. Also, interestingly, mosquitoes are also there in the rubric shamelessness. So interesting. They are full of music and life also. You know, typically when you meet mosquitoes, they'll come very close to crocus also, singing, humming to themselves, dancing. For them, very, very sympathetic towards animals. You'll see these people being very, very compassionate. And that's why they can come very close to Kali or Causticum as well. But the way they are, the way they talk is in a very, very animated way, in a very, very vivacious way. Gesticulating. Irrational talk, and often sometimes very loud talk. How to differentiate with tarantula? Tarantula is a different story altogether. The dancing, the restlessness, the whole idea of cheating and deceitfulness of tarantula is so different. So different. It's a spider quality. One of the very important things about mosquitoes which I have seen is almost every case of mosquitoes I saw has a history of fainting or doing something to gain attention. And a lot of changes in emotions. Weeping alternating with anger, weeping alternating with laughing. So very sudden changeable kind of remedy. Very, very interesting rubric. I want to show you this, a very, very central rubric of mosquitoes is fear of death, talk of death when there is no serious complaint with trembling and palpitation. So interesting. This is one of the most central thing in the case. Very, very central thing of mosquitoes. You know, one of the things I see is most of you guys ask how to differentiate this rubric, with this remedy, this rubric. See, the way I understand remedy is not by rubric. It is by pattern of rubrics. Connecting one rubric to another rubric to another rubric to another rubric. Understanding this pattern and then going and understanding the experience. This is how you understand. There's a lot of fear of death. Delusion death approaching. Delusion dead. delusion he's falling from a height. Most of the time, the state of mind is connected to a lot of chest affections, a lot of breathlessness. They will be magnifying their complaints, yes. But the feeling that everyone against me, this kind of animal quality is how you differentiate it with asafoetida. Because even asafoetida has this fainting and this exaggerated feeling also. But in asafoetida patients, you will see a lot of fear of something will happen. And that's why it belongs to Ambeli family. Somewhere in Moschus and in other mammal remedies, there's always a situation of relationships. And the relationship is often where in Moschus you'll see a lot of either there is a lot of domination of father or fear for his father. So either there's a lot of attachment or a lot of domination from him. So it's like a conflict for them. Fear of death, suffocation, palpitations is very, very strong. Something will happen. Many dreams. For Moschus, their dreams are of being very busy, like Bryonia. Conspiracy. So there's a lot of feeling as if someone is plotting something against them. And that's why Moschus comes very close to Hyoscyamus also. Dreams of conspiracies, dreams defamatory. Another very common dream you'll see in Moschus is that often they will often say that we are trying to catch a train, but train is going away, but I'm still trying to catch. This is often Moschus. Shameful dream, also Moschus. Often Moschus will have a lot of anxiety, and that is connected to the heart region. A lot of anguish, a lot of suffering from inside, but no pathology. It's often a psychological state. How to differentiate arsenic? In arsenic, the deeper state is that of insecurity. A lot of faintness. Always with Moschus, you will see anxiety with faintness. Always with anxiety with respiratory issues. So much of anxiety, especially related to the heart. They have done many ECGs, all are normal. Anxiety, they cannot work. So strange. Also, they can be very, very attached to their mother. Attached very to mother. A lot of potential. A lot of potential. Feeling. A little more, I'm going to tell you a little physical symptom from Moschus before I could cut off the talk. The main genius of Moschus for me, the main genius is lot of spasms. Whenever there is spasms and feeling of coldness, this is the main experience of Moschus. Very often you ask Moschus patient, what do you feel in difficult situation? They'll see spasm with coldness. Faintness, faints very easily. This is also something you'll see. And lot of twitching, they will twitch, jerk, globus, and then unconscious. And that's why it is a very important remedy for tics, dolorex. For a lot of neurological problems, think about Moschus. How to differentiate tarantula? Tarantula will do lot of jerkings when no one is there. That is tarantula. One very important thing I want to tell you. If you understand this, you will understand Moschus, and you will never forget this. This is especially for all of you. Poor reaction. Disease does not follow normal course. This is very important. So many neurological problems, multiple sclerosis, other pathology, they do not have typical symptoms. They have a little strange symptom, so it's very difficult to diagnose them. Moschus is a very strange remedy. The disease also is very strange. Epilepsy with lot of shuddering. One of the very interesting thing is imaginary sufferings is also Moschus. I would say it's more chilly remedy. Someone asked me what the thermals. Yes, a lot of headaches with involuntary stools and polyuria. That makes it a very important remedy for diabetes as well. It would be an important remedy for diabetes. Yes. A lot of neurological nerve related deafness also. A lot of tingling. three sounds from report of cannon, and a lot of jerks of the face, lot of jerk twitchings. This is something you will also see. A lot of desire for black coffee. You'll always see a black coffee in front of them. You know, desire for beer, brandy, but black coffee. You'll see that. And lot of spasms. So there'll be a lot of gastroesophageal reflexes in this patient. Lot of foul flatulence. Diabetes is very, very important. You know, diabetic pathology is very important. This remedy. The sexual desire is very sexual, this remedy will be. The sexual desire very important, with insupportable tickling in parts. Impotence from diabetes, very interesting. Although it's a common symptom, but it's very interesting. Nausea, vomiting after coition, so interesting. So there's a lot of sexuality related in this remedy. Incontrollable titillation in parts in old women. Sexual desire increased with intolerable titillation. So very sexually driven. A lot of nervous suffocation. Extreme, you know, very often patient will tell sudden emotional excitement. My chest just chokes up. Choking. Mujhe choking lag raha. That's very typical of MOSCs. Also, like I told you, many, many cardiac pathology. Anxious palpitation, fear of death. And very often ECG is normal. This is important as well. One hand is hot, another hand is cold, like China, like Lycopodium. And very sleepy by the day, but sleepless at night. A little bit like opium. And typically the fever symptom is also interesting because the sweat is almost smelling like musk, like a perfume. And the body is very cold. That's why it's very important and close to camphor. And everything is better by open air and rubbing and smell of musk. And finally, the aggravating factor is cold, excitement, suppressions, lying on the side, laying on after a meal. So these are all aggravating factors if you want to come to. So this is my email ID. Please write to me what was interesting for you today about MOSCs and the remedy MOSCs and the full drug picture of MOSCs. And also, I've told you about my latest books, and it'll be great for me to have you read my books and tell me your feedbacks about the book. So I